Now, this mind can be likened to an ocean. If you look at the ocean, the sea, you find that we are using only the surface of the sea. That is where all the ships travel. And that is where all the waves are, all the storms are. But if you try to go deep into the ocean, it's very difficult. What happens when you try to go deep into the ocean? Just like imagine, you take a ping pong ball, you go into your bathroom, and you collect some water, you push the ping pong ball into the bottom of the pail, and you let it go. What happens? The ping pong ball is immediately pushed to the surface, right? So that is what happens when we try to go into the ocean. When you try to go into the ocean will push us up. It's not easy to go into the ocean. And you have some people like this, what's his name, that French guy, Jacques Cousteau or something. He built this submarine that went deep into the ocean. Now this submarine, he had to build it so strong that it could go deep into the ocean. Because if you take an ordinary, for example, Milo tin, you close up the Milo tin, and you push it into the bottom of the ocean, you can go a certain way, a certain distance, but you keep on pushing it to the bottom of the ocean, what happens? Slowly that Milo tin will get crushed, Yes or not? So you need something so strong like this, I think you call it a bathyscaphe or something, that submarine that could go into the bottom of the ocean. And when you go to the bottom of the ocean, you find it is so peaceful, so calm, and so powerful inside there. So in the same way, our mind is a bit similar to this ocean. We are using the everyday mind, which is just the surface, just like the surface of the ocean. And this everyday mind is the thinking mind. And this thinking mind is what we call the normal consciousness. Now this normal consciousness, to understand how it works, the Buddha gave a simile. The Buddha gave a simile of a hunter caught six animals. What are these six animals? He caught an eagle, he caught a monkey, he caught a snake, he caught an alligator or crocodile, he caught a dog, he caught a hyena, these six animals. So he tied each animal, he tied with a rope. Okay. So these six ropes, he tied them together, made it into a knot. And he let go of these six animals. What happens when he lets go of these six animals? They all try to take off in a different direction. The eagle wants to fly up into the air, because that's the natural way it goes. The monkey wants to climb up the tree. The snake wants to find a hole to burrow into, because that's the normal hiding place for a snake. And the alligator or crocodile wants to go into the water, because that's the natural home of the alligator. The dog wants to go into town to look for food. The hyena wants to go up the hill, because that's his natural home. So these six animals are pulling in six different directions. Right? At any time, whichever one is the strongest, he will pull, the others have to follow him, right? And when he's tired, some other animal, which is stronger than the rest, will pull, and the others have to follow him, right? That is a very good simile or parable of the working of our mind. Our mind, we have six sense organs, or six senses. One is seeing, hearing, smelling, taste, touch, and thinking. And our attention is pulled by these six sense objects. The eye is pulled by forms. The ear is pulled by sounds. The nose is pulled by smells. The tongue by taste. The body, yeah, by touch. And the thinking mind, is the mano, yeah, is pulled by thoughts. So these six sense objects are pulling in six different directions. And at any one time, whichever one is the strongest, will pull, and your attention is pulled there, right? And then the next moment, another one, your attention is jumping from one object to another. Exactly how the mind works. For example, now you're sitting here listening to me. Suddenly a car goes by and you hear the sound of the car, your attention goes there. And then you come back and listen to me again. Maybe suddenly a mosquito bites you and your attention goes there. And then when you're listening here, suddenly the thought goes back to your home or to your room. You forgot whether you closed the window or not. Tonight it's going to rain. All this thing, right? So that's how the mind works. And your attention is being caught by one object after another. That's the normal working mind.